So you're not the only one dealing with the society. We kids are also dealing with the society. How are we kids dealing with the society? You have issues in terms of, you have to mandatorily turn up at a relative's wedding or something. Similarly, the kids have to turn up at their friend's birthday. That is their society. So you have to understand the importance of the two, where you need to stand out and have your reputation in front of the society. Similarly, the kids too have their reputation to be maintained in their friend circle, that is in their society. So you have to understand them. I'm not saying that what they're doing is right, what you're doing is wrong, but you have to understand. You have to understand their thought process, our thought process, in order to, address it better in a more matured way and give us the right direction. So the way you're concerned about your child's future, he's also concerned. At times they are not. They are just not bothered. Probably because they are, I'm sorry, but they might be spoiled or they don't understand the value for money. But it is proven fact that a person is way more concerned and stressed out in his 20s because he has a lot of uncertainties with respect to his career, whether he's performing well enough in comparison to his friends, what kind of marks is he scoring, is he rich enough, is he cool enough. So there are so many questions that the kids have to answer today. So they have a lot of societal pressure which we have to understand. So it's not that you should not be looking at discarding that altogether. What we need to do is we need to answer that. We need to train them, we need to help them how to answer to that societal pressure. Instead of discarding that, okay, we have the pressure, you don't have any societal pressure, there is no society that you have to live up to. Instead of that, you need to understand their societal pressure. I'm not going to be all on their side, I'm going to come back to all the issues. It's just that I'm trying to bring up all the pointers over here. The way you went through through your teenage, the way these guys are going through their teenage, unfortunately, social media has changed the entire dynamic. You cannot say that when I was in school, I used to study under the street light, or I used to get this much pocket money, and you're getting this much pocket money. Just wait till the child is going to question your inflation and everything. And you did not have cell phone in your childhood. The kid has a cell phone in his childhood. So you have to understand those things. So your day and his day is different. Your struggles and his struggles are different. You had your struggles, no doubt. You have risen above your struggles and worked hard and made your life. And so they do have their own struggles. It is fortunate that they have had an upbringing, a privileged upbringing. But within that privileged upbringing too, they have their pressures. You need to understand their pressures. And you need to give them solutions how to counteract those pressures. You getting it? So that is going to be required because so you cannot, he might be having more mental pressures, you might be having more monetary pressures during your upbringing. So you have to understand his pressures are big for him. I know they are childish. I know they might be childish. They might be naive, immature. But for them, that's a very big problem. That's a very big deal. I know how problematic it could be when someone does not have enough money to feed the members of their family. I know the pressure. I understand that. But for them, the pressure they are facing in school, the peer pressure, anything is very, very huge. So for them, it's not important what. For them, that pressure is that huge. I hope I'm being able to come across. So just the way you might be comparing to your colleague in office, that what is he earning? You might be comparing to the relative, what car is he driving? Just similar to that, he has his own comparison with his friends. Where are his friends holidaying? Where are your friends holidaying? Where are you going for a holiday? What kind of brands are his friends using, and what kind of brands are you using or you are being able to afford to? So I know I'm sorry I'm putting it in a very, very materialistic manner, but that is how it works. But another thing, the problem that happens is that when you have relatives, more or less they're going to be at par with you. Your friends are going to be more or less having the same spending power as you. When you're looking at your colleagues as well in office, you would be hanging around with people more or less around your probably around your paycheck. I'm sorry, I'm getting into the monetary aspect. But when you're looking at the child, he has people from different backgrounds in terms of economic backgrounds, and everybody is studying together. So there is going to be issue in terms of comparison, and trying to look cooler or trying to look richer or something. So we need to understand that first, that he has his peer pressure, and then we need to address it in a very, very matured manner. If we are not going to act matured, how can you expect the child to be acting matured? So we need to understand that aspect. Teach them how to tackle social issues. You will have to teach them how to manage with friends. So if his friends are going for a foreign vacation, he is not. How does he react or how does he manage that in his college? Or say, for example, if his friends are trying alcohol and he does not want to, but then he will feel left out. Or if friends are trying a smoke and he does not want to, but just to fit in, just to not be the loser or the nerd of the group, how does he tackle that situation? So you'll have to explain to him. Like, for example, Akshay Kumar's ad. You know, it's not manly to do foo-foo, but to give the pads to your wife. That is what a real man does. So you have to get them in that language. You're getting it. So you have to teach them how to tackle the social issues because they have their own social pressure and everything. So you have to teach them how to tackle that. You have to have mature communication with them. Otherwise, they will not grow up. They will not be responsible. They need to understand the family situation. Like, for example, I think towards the end of school, you know, this is what we have. This is what we can do for you. These are the opportunities you can get. These are the areas where we can help you. These were the things that my parents had a word with me about. That, you know, this is the amount we can contribute to your education. So if you want to go abroad, for example, you'll have to get a scholarship. This is what we can pay for this. This is the age gap. You know, the age or the time frame that we can allow. After that, you'll probably have to support the family. So you need to have a mature communication. This is how we are prepared for our retirement. So you need to have that mature communication with them. Otherwise, how will they get responsible? They need to know what they are up for, and you cannot give it to them suddenly. So they need to have a gradual this thing about it. The other thing is that when they're doing internships and all, please do not equate everything in terms of money. Because I was very fortunate to have one of the kids in my office, and his father would just wanted him to learn, and it's not about the money aspect. Like, I'll give you an example. In school, in class 6, 7 or so, you know, we used to get those sheets, social work and all that, where we had to probably sell something or collect 20 rupees from all the neighbors and everybody around us, and as much as possible, maybe 100 rupees or 200 rupees to contribute towards a social cause. And I've seen parents complaining about it at times, and that why should we pay, and the school is trying to make money and all. But trust me, today I realize, after reading so much into sales and everything, it is extremely important, because a child needs to, sales is one of the most important things that a child needs to learn. Even if he's a finance guy or he wants to be an engineer or whatever he wants to be, you need to be able to sell yourself. So I believe this is one of the very important skills that we were taught. And today, because of an extraordinary amount of interference, because I talk to the principals of schools and teachers of schools regularly all the time, and you cannot be that interfering with the school as long as the school is fine. And you cannot go and scold the teacher or question the teacher about things. And even if you have to question the teacher, not in front of the child, and because you're ultimately making a mistake. I've seen parents, there is one parent also, two actually, that I've faced, two incidents where the parent came to me and a little disrespectful manner. How will your child learn to respect a teacher in that case? So you cannot do that. And I've seen, where the parents start meddling too much, and how dare you tell me, talk to my kid like that, or my kid cannot stay without an AC like that. And if you are going to be doing all these things, your child is never going to be doing, learning how to manage in difficult situations. And, learn the value of money the value of things. So please don't make these mistakes. You might be rich, but you're spoiling your child's future by doing all these things. So internships, as I was saying, it's not about the money. It's about the learning, how to go to office, how to sit for 8-9 hours at a stretch. Because I see people have such poor attention span that they're not able to sustain in an office for a longer duration. They want things immediately. They want that today I join the office, tomorrow I get a promotion. I deserve so much amount of money immediately, irrespective of what output I'm bringing to the table. So that the entitlement that children have today, and even at work, they are facing so much of an issue in terms of whether they do their own business, when they have to deal with workers, clients. I'm telling you, you're actually creating a recipe for a disaster for your child's future by doing all these things. Please don't take me negatively, with all due respect and your seniority, but you need to understand this. I'm very, very happy that my parents did not, ever question a teacher. If it's my fault, I would get the scolding and it would never be like, you know, how dare you make my child sit without the fan or something. If I have to go to a teacher, if I have to travel a certain time, jao, padhna hai, padho. You have to study, you have to go, you have to travel, you travel, you have to sit without the AC, you sit without the AC. Why do you have to even think about what's around you? You have to focus on your studying part. You see the quality, you understand those things. So you know, even when you have to fill up a sheet and collect 20 rupees from everywhere and submit in the school, understand the reason why these things are done. And a lot of things are being cancelled in the school because of the interference by the parents. So I hope you understand what I'm trying to tell you. It's ultimately for the long-term goal of the child that these things are done. And I also did not understand the importance of these small things that was done in school. But today I'm extremely grateful to my teachers and my principal, father, and everybody, you know, even my tuition teachers and everybody, the way they taught me the value of time. You have to reach on time to the class, and even if the class would be wait, I remember going to one of the teachers and my parents had to wait for 30-40 minutes every time because the teacher would delay the class. So you should be happy about it. You're studying more. Even if you have to wait, it's fine. I mean, or if your class is stretched, you cannot complain. It's not a service that you have subscribe to. It's not an Amazon or something like that. You have to understand the importance of things. They don't have the patience to wait even in a job interview. That full day I was there and they come irritated and frustrated at home. That is because probably the way they have been entitled and treated, that, you know, everything will be served on platter to you. So you can't do that. Even with client meetings or the number of follow-ups you have to do, they're not going to be able to do those things. I remember, you know, doing social work in class 9 and 10 because of the Dublin Exchange, student exchange program in Ireland, and the way we had to do social work, collect sponsorship, and so many other things, and that teaches you a lot of things. So we used to go to people, ask for money. This was a problem that I faced even after I moved back and started on my own. So one of the most difficult things I learned was to ask clients and people for money. That was one of the most difficult conversations I had to have at the beginning. Now I've learned that part as well.